We need to use this box and whisker plot to determine the range of the data and if the numbers in the two middle groups are more spread out above or below the median. Remember, to form a box and whisker plot, the first thing we do is find the median of the set of data. The median is the number that falls directly in the middle when we arrange the terms from smallest to largest. Once we have the median, we label that Q2. So in this case, the median is 45.5. After we have the median, we find the median of the upper half of the data and label that Q3. Then we find the median of the lower half of the data and label that Q1. What this does is it splits the data up into four equal groups. The first group is from the lowest point to Q1. The second group is from Q1 to Q2. The third group is from Q2 to Q3. And the last group is from Q3 to the largest number. Now, in this case, we need to find the range, and then we need to determine whether the numbers in the two middle groups are more spread out above or below the median. So let's start with the range. Remember, the range is the difference between the greatest value and the least. Well, the greatest is here at 81.3, and the least is here at 9.4. So the range is 81.3 minus 9.4, which is 71.9. Now we need to look at the two middle groups of data. That's going to be group 2 and group 3. So the groups between Q1 and Q2 and Q2 and Q3. Now notice that the distance between Q2 and Q3 is much greater than the distance between Q1 and Q2. And remember that Q2 is the median here, and each of these four groups has the same number of terms. Well, if there are the same number of terms in the third group that's more spread out than the second group, we know that the numbers in the two middle groups of data are going to be more spread out above the median, because we have the same number of terms here in a greater distance than we do here. So the final two answers to problem 16 are 71.9, which is the range, and above the median.